unser letzter Ausweg ist just Europa. Wir haben ihnen Punkt keine Rückkehr erreicht. Amerika ist von hinten verlassen worden. Unser Hoffnungen und ihr Geist des Zurückbringens sind dort verlangen. At the conclusion of the First World War, injured national pride, in combination with extensive demands made on Germany in the Treaty of Versailles, threw Germany into depression and disorder. In 1934, Adolf Hitler of the Nazi Party declared himself the Führer of Germany. With the goal of ridding Germany of all Jews and other non-Aryans, the Nuremberg Laws were passed, denying non-Aryans German citizenship and stripping them of their rights. Amidst strong government-endorsed anti-Semitic discrimination and violence, the Nazis encouraged the Jews to emigrate. In 1938, President Roosevelt called a conference in Avignon, France, where 32 countries met to discuss Jewish refugee policy. All but the Dominican Republic refused to raise their immigration quotas due to economic difficulties. In Germany, the Nazis began deporting Jews who did not leave to ghettos and concentration camps.
She found out he was in Dachau. My mother, she made plans to get out of the country, because the only way to get him back out of Dachau was to leave Germany. And so she made arrangements for us to get out of Germany on a ship called the St. Louis.
The SS St. Louis was docked at Hamburg when 937 passengers boarded it, with the hope that it would bring them to a better life. All but six passengers were Jews fleeing Nazi persecution. Several of the passengers, including Rudolf Jacobson's father, had been interned in concentration camps and only released on the condition that they leave Germany, never to return. The St. Louis was bound for Havanna, Cuba, but most of the passengers planned to use Cuba as a stepping stone to the United States. On May 13, 1939, the St. Louis departed from Hamburg, Germany. Despite the Nazi flag flying above, the atmosphere on the voyage was pleasant. Captain Gustav Schroeder had given orders to the mostly Nazi crew that the Jewish refugees were to be treated just as any other passengers. The St. Louis arrived in Havana on May 27, 1939. Unknown to the passengers, the landing passes they had bought were worthless. While Cuban law welcomed tourists, but required refugees to buy visas, it never defined either. In early 1939, the Cuban Director of Immigration, Manuel Benitez Gonzalez, had manufactured landing passes defining the bearers as tourists and had sold them to the refugees at a large profit. When the Cuban president, Laredo Bru, saw that Benitez was making money, he signed Decree 937, voiding the landing passes. When the St. Louis arrived in Havana, the passengers were not allowed to debark as their landing permits were not recognized. The atmosphere on the ship became tense. A passenger wrote a note to President Bru, "Please help me, President Bru, or we will be lost," and threw it overboard in a bottle.
But I remember us being in the harbor. I remember the little boats coming out with relatives of the people on the ship, waving, husbands waving at wives that were on the ship that couldn't get off.
On May 28th, Lawrence Berenson of the Jewish Joint Distribution Committee arrived in Havana from the United States. He spent the next 5 days negotiating directly with President Bru. Bru demanded that the committee post a $453,500 bond, $500 per passenger. When Berenson made a counteroffer, Bru broke off negotiations until the St. Louis left Cuban waters. On June 2nd, the St. Louis left Havana. Family members yelled their goodbyes to their families in the harbor. A passenger described their departure, an indescribable drama of human concern and despair played on us as we sailed into the twilight of uncertainty. This is one of the most tragic days on board as we feel cheated for the freedom that we had hoped for. What started as a voyage of freedom is now a voyage of doom. In Havana, after several days of negotiation, Bru's demand was the same, $500 per passenger. Cuba, like the rest of the world, was in a depression. There had been a significant rise in the foreign Jewish population, and the Cuban government didn't want foreigners to take the jobs that could belong to their citizens. Even though the refugees ultimately wanted to get to America, the immigration quotas to the United States were such that there would be a 3 to 4 year wait in Cuba before they got to the United States. The Cubans saw the Jewish refugees as a burden. On June 6th, Bru closed negotiations entirely, saying that Berenson had missed a 48-hour deadline that Berenson had not known existed. There was no hope for the St. Louis to land in Cuba. Captain Schroeder turned the ship north and headed for the coast of Florida, hoping that the United States would allow them to land. A passenger wrote, "America was a magic word. We knew America would not let us down." The St. Louis cruised up the Florida coast. A telegram was sent to President Roosevelt, begging for his assistance. The president ignored the message. American newspapers reported of the tragic liner wandering aimlessly in Florida waters. America was in the Great Depression. Jobs were scarce, and more people would be a burden on the economy. Also, Breckinridge Long, an assistant secretary of state, and several of his subordinates had strong anti-Semitic sentiments and actively worked against the admission of German refugees. The final response to the ship was issued by the State Department. The German refugees must await their turn before they may be admissible to the United States. The St. Louis was forced to turn back to Germany. Captain Schroeder promised not to force anyone back to Germany that did not want to go. Provisions would be made in other countries for their emigration. Morris Troper of the Jewish Joint Distribution Committee negotiated with several countries in Europe, and as a result of his successful diplomacy, on June 17th, the passengers debarked in Antwerp, Belgium. From there, they were distributed across Western Europe. 224 to France, 214 to Belgium, 181 to Holland, and 287 to Britain. The ship had landed, the voyage was over, but the consequences were only beginning. Rudolf Jacobson and his family were in the group of 181 passengers sent to Holland. They stayed there until family members from Wisconsin sent them money to buy passage to America. He arrived in the United States February 5th, 1940. Elsa Blumenstein also went to Holland. In 1940, she tried to leave for the Dominican Republic, but couldn't get out of then-occupied Holland. After hiding from the Nazis for 3 years, Elsa Blumenstein was deported to Auschwitz, where she was murdered. Rudy Dingfelder also settled in the Netherlands. He was arrested by the Gestapo on October 9, 1942, and was taken to Westerbork concentration camp, where he was selected for forced labor. He survived Vought concentration camp, Auschwitz, and Buchenwald. He escaped during a death march in 1945 and emigrated to the United States the next year. The failed diplomacy between the Jewish Joint Distribution Committee and Cuba and the United States had dire consequences for many of the passengers of the St. Louis.
There was 900 approximately went back to Europe. Only about a third survived. The rest of them were all caught up a second time when the Nazis invaded the lowlands there in 40.
But the ultimate significance of the St. Louis being turned away wasn't the fate of the passengers, but the fate of the 6 million Jews that perished in the Holocaust. The rejection of the St. Louis showed the world that the Jews were unwanted, even by the United States. The discrepancies about the landing permits and visas, and the failed diplomacy in solving these discrepancies, showed the Nazis that emigration, even of only 900 Jews, was too difficult. Emigration had failed. The Nazis needed a new solution, a final solution. In 1942, the Reich Ministry secretaries met for a luncheon at Wannsee. In their meeting, they discussed the removal of Jews from Europe by deportment to concentration camps and ghettos, and then immigration to other countries. The minutes of the conference read, "Financial difficulties, such as the demand by various foreign governments of increasing sums of money to be presented at the time of landing, increasing restriction of entry permits, or the canceling of such, increased extraordinarily the difficulties of emigration." It was at the Wannsee conference that the Nazis decided to give up emigration and to implement the final solution.
This, you could almost say, was the beginning of the final solution. Here is a ship of 937 Jews, and the great Western democracies wouldn't even take them.
The failed diplomacy resulting in the rejection of the St. Louis by Cuba and the United States was a significant contributing factor to the Nazis' realization that emigration had failed. It was because emigration failed that the Nazis felt that the final solution was necessary.